It's Saturday, 25th August, and this is Top Stories by Rooster News. Speaking at the 150th year celebrations of Lady Sivaswamy Iyer Girls Higher Secondary School in Chennai, Ms. Sitharaman, Defence Minister, said, "I want more girls in the armed forces. I'm going to give you a challenge. Tell me what you're going to do to get more girls to the Rashtriya Military Academy, Short Service Commission, and after that aspire to be part of the Indian Army, Indian Air Force and the Indian Navy." She said that the school had faced great challenges in these past 150 years and had provided education to less privileged girls as well. "Next year, make sure that your girls come and tell me, Short Service Commission, I am here. I would like to see them as fighter pilots. They should be part of my Indian Navy. We should see them. They are all girls, but they should be in the frontier breaking areas," the defense minister said. Ms. Sitharaman also said Tamil Nadu's school curriculum needed to see definitive and substantive changes. "The curriculum needs to be more dynamic. I don't know why the number of people from Tamil Nadu who used to crack IAS, IPS, Foreign Service, IIT, IISc exams have come down. Even in governance, we find very few Tamils coming into the system," she said. NITI Aayog has identified three major sectors, health, education and children's health, as priority sectors for intervention, said NITI Aayog Vice Chairperson Rajiv Kumar. "About 38% of children are malnourished, while 50% have mothers who are anemic. We have to get rid of the malnourishment and anemia from the country. How can we talk about demographic dividend when children remain malnourished?" said Mr. Kumar, addressing the Odisha Vikas Conclave in 2018. Stating that the goal of universalization of education has been achieved, he said, "It is time to assess the states on the quality parameter. NITI Aayog is preparing a mechanism to rank states on the basis of education quality achieved." Similarly, the center is planning to set up 1.5 lakh health and wellness centers across India, as the existing primary health centers were not functioning properly, said Mr. Kumar. The new health centers would have telemedicine facilities apart from other modern equipment, he added. Following a hacking of servers of Pune-headquartered Cosmos Bank, rupees 78 crore was withdrawn physically from 28 countries including the UK and USA using cloned ATM cards, the police said yesterday. On August 11th and 13th, unidentified hackers targeted the bank's ATM Swiss server and stole details of Visa and Rupee ATM cards. They also attacked the Interbank SWIFT system and siphoned off rupees 94 crore in total. The United Kingdom, United States, Russia, United Arab Emirates and Canada are among the 28 countries from where rupees 78 crore was withdrawn physically using clone cards, said Jyoti Priya Singh, Deputy Commissioner of Police, Cyber and Economic Offences Wing. The cyber cell was getting in touch with law enforcement agencies of these countries for further action, she added. The cyber cell's aim now is to find out the money mules who were used to withdraw the money using ATMs in foreign countries. In a new war of nerves between them, the United States and Pakistan have contradicted each other on whether terrorism was discussed during a congratulatory phone call to Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan by Secretary of State Mike Pompeo on Thursday. Pakistan refuted the state government statement that terrorism was discussed during the call. In response, the State Department reiterated that it stood by the earlier rhetoric but did not specifically restate that terrorism was discussed. The Trump administration is walking a tightrope on its ties with Pakistan amid new attempts to open talks with the Taliban in Afghanistan. In the readout on the call that riled Pakistan, Ms. Nawert had said, "Secretary Pompeo expressed his willingness to work with the new government towards a productive bilateral relationship. Secretary Pompeo raised the importance of Pakistan taking decisive action against all terrorists operating in Pakistan and its vital role in promoting the Afghan peace process." Pakistan Foreign Office spokesperson Mohammad Faisal contradicted the readout with a Twitter post. Pakistan takes exception to the factually incorrect statement issued by the US State Department on today's phone call between PM Khan and Sec Pompeo. There was no mention at all in the conversation about terrorists operating in Pakistan. This should immediately be corrected. The Chennai Corporation will launch its cycle-sharing scheme in Anna Nagar in October. Besant Nagar and Marina Beach will also be covered. The dockless cycle-sharing system will roll out with 250 bicycles fitted with GPS in the first phase. We have started mapping locations in Anna Nagar this week. Metro stations will get last-mile connectivity with a large number of cycles and feeder stations, said an official. Commuters will be able to pick up a cycle near metro stations in Anna Nagar and leave them at any of the feeder stations spread across the area on payment of a charge. An app will be created for the project next month. We round up this newscast with fuel prices from key metros. In Delhi, petrol is sold for 77.72 rupees per litre and diesel for 69.23 rupees per litre. In Chennai, petrol is sold for 80.74 rupees per litre and diesel for 73.13 rupees per litre. In Kolkata, petrol is sold for 80.66 rupees per litre and diesel for 72.07 rupees per litre. In Mumbai, petrol is sold for 85.14 rupees per litre and diesel for 73.49 rupees per litre.